Maureen O'Sullivan was an Irish-American actress who starred in 6 Tarzan films. She's considered one of the best actresses in both Ireland and America. In this video, we'll take a look at her life and her tragic death. Song of My Heart. Maureen was born Maureen Paula O'Sullivan in Boyle to Mary Eva Lovett and Charles Joseph O'Sullivan. Her father served in the British Army during World War I. One of her classmates at her school in Dublin was future Academy Award-winning actress Vivian Leigh. She moved to New York with her mother in 1929. She'd always been interested in becoming an actress, so when she found out that film director Frank Borzage was in Dublin shooting his film Song of My Heart, Maureen was more than ecstatic. She met Borzage and he asked her to take a screen test. He was impressed and gave her the role of Eileen O'Brien in the movie. Maureen later traveled to the U.S. to finish the film and was given a role in another film called So This Is London, MGM and Tarzan. 2 years after the release of Song of My Heart, Maureen got a contract with MGM. Film producer Irving Thalberg selected her for the role of Jane Parker in the 1932 film Tarzan the Ape Man. She starred in lots of other MGM films throughout the 30s, and between the years 1932 and 1942, she appeared in a total of 6 Tarzan films. Tarzan the Ape Man, Tarzan and His Mate, Tarzan Escapes, Tarzan Finds a Son, Tarzan's Secret Treasure, and Tarzan's New York Adventure. She was one of the most popular MGM actresses in the 30s. In 1934, she starred alongside William Powell and Myrna Loy in the 1934 comedy mystery film, The Thin Man. When she was interviewed in 1992, she spoke about Myrna Loy saying, "What was her magic? I don't know, she was just magic." She also starred in the film adaptation of Leo Tolstoy's novel, Anna Karenina, in 1935 with Greta Garbo. She co-starred with Marx Brothers in the 37 film A Day at the Races. O'Sullivan's Hollywood career never stalled, and she was always up to something. In 1938, she starred as Molly Beaumont in A Yank at Oxford, a film that was co-written by novelist F. Scott Fitzgerald. In 1940, she starred in Pride and Prejudice alongside Laurence Olivier and Greer Garson. Irvin Thalberg and MGM co-founder Louis B. Mayer both had big plans for O'Sullivan. They wanted to turn her into a big star. But Thalberg suddenly died in 1936, and no other person at MGM was willing to help O'Sullivan achieve the level of fame that Thalberg had envisioned for her, leaving MGM. In 1942, she did her 6th and final Tarzan film, called Tarzan's New York Adventure. After finishing the film, she decided to quit MGM because she wanted to take care of her husband, John Farrow, who had just left the Canadian Navy and was struggling with typhoid. O'Sullivan and Farrow married in 1936, and they had 7 children together. After she was released from her contract, she took a short break, but returned to the silver screen in 1948 as Georgette Stroud in the film The Big Clock. The film was directed by her husband. She starred in the 1950 noir thriller film Where Danger Lives, also directed by her husband. Throughout the 1950s, she starred in a number of films that were directed by Farrow, but by the early 60s, she decided it was time to retire from Hollywood. Theater. After she retired from films, she decided to try her hand at performing in theater. At the request of actor Pat O'Brien, she performed in the play A Room Full of Roses in 1961. She soon made her Broadway debut in a play called Never Too Late, co-starring Paul Ford. The play ran for over 1,000 performances from 1961 to 1965. The play was later turned into a film, and O'Sullivan reprised her role of Edith Lambert. Around the same time, she was also working as an executive director of a bridal service called Wedekut International. Her husband, Farrow, died of a heart attack in 1963. O'Sullivan continued to perform in theater, and in 1972, she starred in a play called Butterflies Are Free. TV and acting with her daughter. O'Sullivan began appearing in TV shows in 1952 when she appeared on an episode of Hollywood Opening Night. She made appearances on shows like Lux Video Theater, the Ford Television Theater, Pin Case, and Heart to Heart. She also hosted a TV show of her own for a while. It was called Irish Heritage. Some other shows she appeared in were Today, The Guiding Light, and The Great Houdinis. One of her daughters, Mia Farrow, is a Golden Globe Award-winning actress. She starred in a couple of Woody Allen films, and she was also involved romantically with him. O'Sullivan starred as Farrow's mother in Hannah and Her Sisters. When Allen and Farrow broke up, O'Sullivan said, "Allen is a desperate and evil man." She also starred in the 1986 fantasy comedy drama Peggy Sue Got Married, the 1987 science fiction film Stranded, and she made a cameo appearance in the 1985 horror film Too Scared to Scream. These are some of her last roles. Her final film was the 1988 film The River Pirates, in which she starred as Aunt Sue. Her daughter, Mia Farrow, named one of her sons, Satchel Ronan O'Sullivan Farrow. By the late 1980s, O'Sullivan's career had pretty much come to an end. Death. O'Sullivan died in 1998 at Scottsdale Memorial Hospital due to complications from heart surgery. She was 87 at the time of her death, and she's left behind by her second husband, James Cushing, a businessman. In an interview with the Associated Press, she said, "It's nice to be immortal. Film has given us immortality. Now my children are going to appreciate Tarzan." O'Sullivan died in 1998, but it's clear that her spirit still lives on in the hearts of all those people who grew up watching her films and in her children. She has a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. She was given the George Eastman Award for her contribution to film. She never won any Academy Awards, but let's be honest, an actress of her caliber didn't need to win any award to prove how talented she was. So what's your favorite Maureen O'Sullivan film? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button.